this video, we're going to be talking about limit rules. For limit rules, there are about 8 of them. So, the first one we're going to talk about is the constant function. When there's limit of k with x going towards c from the left side, the answer is still going to be k. For example, limit of 6 is still going to equal 6 even though x is going towards 2. It's going to be constant. So 6 is going to be equal 6, 7 is going to equal 7, everything like that. The second one we're going to talk about is identity function. For this one, you have limit of x from x going in the direction of c, it's going to equal c. Whatever direction it's going in, whatever it's going to, that's what it's going to equal. For the third rule, it's the sum rule. For the sum rule, you have limit of f of x plus g of x. And then you want to break that down even more to limit of f of x with x going towards c plus limit of g of x going towards c. An example of that is limit of x plus 2 with x going towards 2. So you break it down to limit of x plus limit of 2. Then you just plug in where the x is going towards, which is 2, for the x. So you have 2 plus 2 equals 4. The next rule we have is the difference rule. So you have limits of f of x minus g of x going towards c. So for this one, you just break it down like we did the sum one. F of x minus limit of g of x. An example is limit x minus 5 with x going towards 6. And then you just do limit of x minus limit of 5. And you're going to end up with 6 minus 5, which equals 1. The next rule is the constant multiple rule, rule number 5. So you have limit of k of f of x, which is going to equal k limit of f of x. So whatever your constant number is right here, when reducing and going down to simplify everything to get to your final answer, you just put it right in front of the limit. An example is limit of 2x you just put 2 limit of x, then eventually you plug your 5 in, and that gives you 10. Your next rule is your product rule. For your product rule, it's just limit of f of x, g of x, and then you can just break that down also. So limit of f of x times limit of g of x. It's going to be the same for the next rule, which is going to be our quotient rule. So you have limit of f of x over g of x. You just break that down. It's going to be limit f of x over limit of g of x. for our last and final rule, it's the exponent rule. So you have limit of f of x to your exponent. An example is when you have limit of square root of x to the third, this square root equals 1/2. If I had a 3 here, it would equal 1/3. But this equals 1/2. So you have x to the third of 1/2.